Hi, you guys, it's Crystal Sherelle. This is the Indie Artist School, and today we are going to talk about the fundamentals of singing. This is something that no matter what your level of knowledge on this already is, you're gonna need to learn these three things. Okay, all right, so the first step is learning how to breathe. I can't stress this enough, you guys. I want you to think of breathing as the foundation. Without good breath, the whole thing falls apart. The importance of this is so that you can actually have enough to sing through your phrases, each line, each note, and you will have different levels of amount of pressure, and we're gonna talk about this as we go through here. Okay, so how do you breathe? The very first thing you need to learn is how to have an upright posture. Your body is your instrument, you guys, so that if you are slouching or leaning too far back, what you're doing is you're putting a strain on your muscles, and what it does is it hinders your breath capacity. So if I were to hunch over like this, and like I had my back and chest caved in, and I was to try to take a deep breath, I'm very limited at how full of a breath I can take. You can try it right now where you're at, in your chair, standing up, wherever you are. I want you to try to hunch down over and try to take a deep breath in. It's like so much is working against you, right? You don't want to put gravity against you. By having an upright posture, it really helps you make it easier on yourself. Another thing about leaning too far back, even when you're standing, some people just naturally stand like that. What that does is it engages your abdominal muscles a little bit too much, and that's also hard for you to take a full breath. Why am I talking about the stomach, you might wonder? That's because the fundamental place for breathing when you're singing is from your diaphragm. Your diaphragm is actually pretty contrary to where most people breathe. If you've never sung before, you're probably breathing like this. You see how as I'm breathing right now like that, one, it's shallow. Two, you notice my shoulders and my chest and my back are going up and down. It's very visibly noticeable when I take a breath like that. And it's using so much more effort than necessary. And the sad thing is, it has no return, guys. It's not going to be as useful, even though it takes that much more effort to take that breath in from your chest. It's not gonna actually support your voice for singing. So you're probably wondering, okay, if I'm not supposed to breathe like that, how am I supposed to be breathing, okay? And that's where diaphragmatic breathing comes in. So this is going to be breathing from what looks like your stomach, okay? And it's not truly your stomach, but it is in this area. So as you breathe in, wherever you are, I want you to put your hands around your waist, right below your rib cage. And what your goal is as you breathe in, to make your hands go outwards, okay? Rather than caving inwards. Like if you were to breathe from your chest, your stomach is actually going to be going in. But instead, as we breathe in, you see that? First of all, you might notice if you just hear that breath, so much more full, guys, so much more full. And another cool benefit of breathing from your diaphragm is that it is actually relaxing and calming to your nervous system. And it leads into our second point, which is support. Okay, so now you've learned how to take your breath in from your diaphragm. And honestly, if it's hard for you to get at first, I completely understand. Don't worry about it. What I want you to do is stand in front of a mirror and practice breathing from your diaphragm. Another way you can practice breathing from your diaphragm, step one, is to lay on the floor. This is a fun one, honestly. I want you to lay on the floor and put a book or your iPad or whatever on your stomach. And as you breathe in, while you're laying flat on the floor, I mean, your back is on the ground, you're just completely neutral in position, your legs are relaxed, your whole body is just relaxed. That's gonna force your posture to stay neutral, okay? That's the first thing it does. The second thing it does is it makes it a lot easier for you to know if you're breathing from your chest or your diaphragm, okay? How can you tell? The first thing you can do is make sure as you breathe in that that book or that whatever item you put on your stomach is actually going up towards the ceiling as you breathe in. So if you're laying flat, honestly, this is horrible. But anyway, we're going to pretend this marker is me laying on the ground, right? And then I put this, let's just, this phone is on my belly. As I breathe in, that's what's happening, okay? So you can try this at home. You can do it in your bed when you're about to go to bed. It doesn't even have to be a big deal, guys. This is something you could just practice first thing in the morning, right before you hop out of bed. Try it while you're laying down. Or about to go to bed, need to calm your nerves, try it then, okay? Just make sure your bed is flat, okay? Some people got those incline and reclining beds. It's very important that your body is in a neutral posture. Either you're laying completely flat on the ground or you're standing completely straight up, okay? Or even if you're sitting in a chair, you can do this whether you're sitting, standing, or laying flat. If you're sitting in a chair, you want to make sure your back is straight, your shoulders are back, and your feet are flat on the ground. That's how you keep a neutral position, a neutral posture when you're sitting, okay? So hopefully that makes sense. We got step one squared away. All right, step two, support. Now, we just filled up our stomach, for lack of a better word. Well, there is a better word, diaphragm. Okay, we just filled that up with air. Okay, really it's your lungs, but you're gonna notice as you expand your stomach, it's way more visible to see your stomach. So you filled it up with air, and now it's time to use it to sing a note. Okay, so you may be wondering, how do I use my diaphragm to, here's the deal, project, okay? So this is how you support or project a note. So you filled it up and we're gonna pretend you're still laying down on the ground, okay? And you're about to sing a note. Well, you raised it up to take that breath in, but instead of just pushing your stomach inwards to sing that note, what you're gonna do is use these muscles on your sides called intercostal muscles to push out instead, okay? So if you were laying on the ground, it would be like, ho, ha, ha, okay? Your stomach's going up, 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 up every time you need to project a note. And if you were standing upright, it's going outwards as you project a note, okay? Another way to think of it is the belly laugh. You ever see Santa Claus or something like that? Ho, ho, ho. His belly's just jiggling, okay? I'm not saying you gotta be self-conscious about your belly to do this, but I'm just saying, I want you to visualize your stomach going out as you project your note, okay? So that's how you support your note. And here's another clue, guys. Even if it's not a fast note like ho, 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 and it's a long note, what you're gonna learn is, this comes with training, but you're gonna learn how to control how long your stomach projects out and how long it takes for it to gradually come back in, okay? So that's how you can sustain a long note. So you can project and you can sustain. Okay, you can sustain, hold notes, shorten notes. It doesn't matter. No matter what, every note you sing has to be supported, okay? So these are fundamental things for singing, okay? Whether you want to belt, whether you want to sing something softly, whether you want to, you know, try to sing a note from different registers. We're going to talk about that later, but anyway. No matter what you're trying to do, you got to be breathing from your diaphragm and you've got to be supporting it as well from your diaphragm. So everything is happening from your diaphragm. If you notice, and this is something I'm just going to address right now. If you notice as you're singing, your chest is collapsing, okay? You're going, ha, ha. I don't know. That's just like some random note. It's so weird trying to sing incorrectly. But anyway, ha, ha. Okay, so like, my chest is caving in. It lacks support. And while you can get away with it a little bit, I can tell you this. One, you're going to be very limited in what you're able to sing. Two, you're going to notice that over time, you're going to get vocal fatigue. Your throat is going to get tired when you sing, and you're going to wonder, why am I so tired? That's because you're not supporting it, okay? Can you imagine trying to build a house and you have no foundation? And you got no support. Everything's just falling apart. You're just putting bricks up and they're falling on the ground. You're like, why is this not working? Well, if you're feeling like that, chances are you haven't done step one and step two correctly, okay? So that's how you support yourself, is instead of, I'm sorry, I'm being goofy now. All right, instead of projecting from your chest, you're gonna go, ha. You see how my belly got involved? First of all, you probably noticed that my voice is a lot more supported. Ha, ha. See how my stomach's going out to support it? Ha, ha. And notice something, my chest and my shoulders are not involved. They're not involved. I'm neutral in my position. I'm projecting only from my diaphragm, okay? All right, so now the third thing. This is a tricky one for some people, for most people, because trying to tackle step three before you got step one and step two is nearly impossible. But we're gonna talk about it now because you know what step one and two are. Vocal placement. Okay, we're gonna talk about vocal placement. What is vocal placement anyway? Okay, vocal placement has to do with the shape of your mouth as you sing certain notes. You may be wondering, what does that have to do with anything? Well, here's the deal. In every person's voice, they have different registers. Ooh, registers. We're gonna talk about registers now. Okay, so it doesn't matter what type of voice you have. If you got a really low note, really low voice way down here, or if you got a really high voice way up here, it doesn't matter. Everybody has a range, a vocal range, meaning you've got a span of notes that you can go. So some people got two octaves. This is an example of two. So they got all of these notes in their arsenal. These are all the notes that they are able to sing without feeling like they are about to die. Okay, so if you've got all of these notes in your range, here's the deal. Each one of these notes are not going to be sung the same way, okay? There's a register called the chest, okay? We're going to call this chest voice. Okay, your chest voice is where you naturally speak. It's usually the lowest parts of your voice, okay, guys? For everybody, it's the lowest parts of your voice. It's going to feel very natural. It's when, as you sing these notes and speak these notes, if you were to put your hand on your chest, you're going to feel some vibration in your chest. Like as I'm talking right now, I feel my chest vibrating. But here's the deal. I'm not pushing from there, though. I'm not pushing from my chest. It's just that's where it's resonating. That's where it vibrates the most. But if I were to talk up here, woo, 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 way up here, now my chest is not vibrating at all. I'm in my head voice. That's the highest part of my voice, okay? So now we've got head voice. That's way up there. But there's this interesting, fun, little, weird little register called the mixed register. And it is a blend. Sorry. It is a blend of these two. Mixed register is usually where most people have the most trouble. It's if you were to sing a scale. You hear how I just shifted all of my registers? Well, there's this middle part where people's voices usually want to crack. You may notice as you're going up that it feels uncomfortable. You might feel like you're straining to get the notes. Like if I were to sing like that, that would be me trying to force my chest voice up where it doesn't need to be, when I need to actually be in my mixed voice. So as you're singing these registers, you may notice that you can't sing every note in your chest register. You can't sing it in the same way. You're going to notice you're straining. You're going to notice your voice is cracking, and you're going to be trying to figure out why. Maybe I just don't have a wide vocal range. I'm here to tell you that that's not true, guys. If you're feeling like your vocal range is tiny just because you can't sing it in chest voice, let me tell you something. Once you learn vocal placement, you're gonna expand your vocal range naturally. How? It's because you're gonna be able to master each one of your registers and sing them properly. So how do you do that? Okay, I know it sounds like I'm speaking something that's a dream or something that's not even real. Everything I'm telling you right now is tried and true. You guys don't even understand. I've been teaching so many people for so long, hundreds of students, and every single person that has come to me has either had one of these issues. Every single person. Not one student had all these figured out. Let that settle. Come on. Let it settle. What? Yes. These three things. And a lot of them have even had other teachers, but they didn't address all three of these things. And then you might wonder, well, I know about it. Okay, well, mastery is a whole nother thing. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about vocal placement, which kind of seems elusive to most people. This one right here, step number three, gets overlooked the most. It really does. And the reason why is because a lot of people don't understand it. Okay, so the best way I like to teach everyone when they first come in here to understand their chest voice is to experiment with different vowel sounds, okay? These shapes are gonna change your vocal placement. I want you to do me a favor. Right now, wherever you are, I want you to say the sound E. Okay, just say E with me. E. Okay, so as you say E, you may notice that it's a lot more forward. E, E, it's in the front of your mouth. But if you were to say the word O, say that, O, well, your voice is completely shaped differently, isn't it? Okay, so here's the deal. Ooh, oh, that's a little different than O. All of the vowel sounds, E, I, O, ooh, eh, all of these, ah, ah, they all have different vocal shapes. They all have different shapes. And these all can change your vocal placement. Here's the deal though. There's a proper way to sing, no matter what vowel you're singing, to sing a proper vowel in each one of these registers, okay? Now, I'd be here all day if I told all you guys everything about that right now. It's a lot better to do this one-on-one, okay? And, if I had all the time in the world, to just give you this information for free like this, and if you got the time to sit here for hours, we'll go through it. But here's the deal. Once you just this simple thing will help you right now. You don't have to know every single vowel, vocal placement, vowel shape for each one of these registers, but just being aware of when your voice is changing into a new register can completely change your vocal range, okay? So one thing I want you to do is if you're in your chest voice and you feel yourself straining, I want you to change it to, so you're in chest, ah, and when you get here, I want you to go, the I sound will help you open up to your mixed voice. The I sound. Now, as you keep going, now I'm starting to switch over to an E sound. So I want you to be in E when you go up to your head voice. If you find tension, I want you to switch your vowel sound. A lot of times when people do vocal warm-ups and they're trying to figure out their vocal range, they're doing everything with an ah or an ah or something like that. And that's fine in the beginning. Well, honestly, I'm not even gonna lie. It's not better to start that way, but a lot of people do. My thing is, quick fix, you find yourself, your voice wanting to crack, change the vowel sound. Experiment with new vowel sounds and feel how that shape opens up your voice so much more, you guys. And by you understanding the shape of that sound, you'll be able to say the word, the sound ooh in an ih space, okay? With that same shape that you have on ih, you'll be able to say ih, all in the same place, okay? The same shape. This is really groundbreaking, you guys. This is something that you can do right now, okay? And just doing that right now, it'll help you open up your vocal range, because chances are if you find yourself having your voice cracking like that, or if you find it so hard to sing, it doesn't need to be that hard anymore, you guys. Just change the shape of your mouth when you're singing. But again, you can't master step three without getting step two and step one, but this right here can change your life. Knowing one through three like this, just knowing these three things, really knowing these, can completely change the game. You guys use this information and learn more. Go ahead and visit my website, indie-artist.teachable.com. I'll send you singing tips to your email, and also you can book a consultation with me so you can get one-on-one lessons so that I can walk you through your own voice, okay? Your own voice, help you understand where your registers are and help you master your own voice. Understand, like, do you really got breathing down? I mean, really, do you? You know, if you don't know, maybe you need to book a consultation with me. Do you have step two? You know, do you know how to support your voice? A lot of times it's hard for you to know what you've really got down. You need a second pair of eyes with training to actually help you. And this is something you can do in the mirror, but if you don't know what to look for, I can tell you right now, it's going to be hard to troubleshoot, but just knowing this right here is a huge step. You're taking a step in the right direction just by knowing this information and being committed to actually learning these three steps. It's three steps. Isn't that amazing? It's three steps. I mean, really, get this. I can help you learn your favorite song in just 7 days. I don't know how long it's been. It's been like, what, 21 minutes? 21 minutes, okay. We went through the fundamentals of singing, okay, in 21 minutes. So trust me when I say I can teach you to learn your favorite song. I mean, really sing it in just 7 days. If you want to learn how to do that, go ahead and visit my website, indie-artist.teachable.com. Anyway, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I'll see you on the other side.